set this real quick. We've got Texas. And Blake. All right, good to go.
Looks like we're going great. Jack Sales player 3, and Blake is player 4.
Blake's even one, even in melee, is really nasty.
Yeah. It's kind of weird because nobody really knows the Game & Watch matchup.
Right,
you kind of have to learn it as you play Blake.
Blake, I know, does abuse the down air and the neutral air, the parry.
Yeah, he loves down tilt.
Oh, right.
If you're right next to Game & Watch, you can pretty much guarantee he's going to down tilt.
Right.
So, like, he comes in, an aerial lands, you should probably just keep, you can just keep shielding until the down tilt hits your shield.
Right. I don't know if the down tilt outreaches Marth's down tilt, though, so...
No, it definitely doesn't, but it is just massive.
Right.
It's pretty close to, like, even on shield, so a lot of times it functions kind of like a shine when it's kind of laggy.
Oh, yes. Blake did go from green Game & Watch to blue now.
Probably my game. Jax is probably scared of the blue.
Right, yes. Like, we all know Jax is afraid of blue.
Yeah, the big problem with Game & Watch is Game & Watch is incredibly light.
Right.
Which we just saw how far it was really good there.
That was like
55%.
Right, yeah.
Game & Watch is also a big weakness is the shield. His shield is... it's actually useless. It really is.
There we go.
Which I guess is somewhat kind of weird for Marth probably because... yeah, I saw Blake actually... Instead of using the normal shield, he was using the light shield.
Because I can't hear anything anyway, so I just have the mic. But, pretty even so far.
Yeah.
Two stocks apiece, a little bit of a percentage, but maybe not.
Yeah, I think just to be a little bit more precise about the spacing, that was a bad
idea. Like I said, that neutral air has so much priority over any other area.
Yeah, you don't really want to challenge it this time.
Right, even with like his down air, I believe the neutral air does the most of that. Right. Blake's, I think, comfortable enough now. He's warmed up enough.
He's kind of just in control. Sounds like a podcast.
Right, lots of pressure.
I just see a kill right now.
Let's get some good patience with Jax. Is there a way to land?
Jax just gave him the victory.
Right.
I think he should have grabbed and tried to beat him. You want to come out of line, can't land like this.
Right.
His recovery is really, he has a lot of drift in the air, so most of the time, Game & Watch will be able to land on the stage, but he can usually hit it back off pretty easily.
I think he's going to pan probably Yoshi's down. I don't know. Like I said, with platforms, it's pretty hard to play against the Marth. So I'd go to Pokemon Stadium.
It's probably more of just a comfort thing. Jax is probably, Jax is playing Blake 7 times.
Right.
Maybe if it's like, even if it's not the, on paper best place to go.
Right.
I think it's still definitely much better. This whole matchup is obviously much safer.
Right. So just knowing the matchup too.
The matchup, obviously has more knowledge.
Right. It's really easy to.
Blake's also a good player.
Baiting that bacon into a down air for a down tilt to your hand. That is one of the nastiest.
It's kind of like, I mean, he shouldn't be getting that if people aren't missing. It's pretty, it is kind of a slow start.
Right.
Plenty of offense. Looks good at feeling when they're not going to get ready to, like,
right.
It is hard to react to things.
It's hard to punish.
I enjoy
that. He's catching Jax trying to shield grab a lot.
He's seeing Jax's
shield, and he's immediately getting hit by down tilt, which shows that Jax is trying to do something on his shield, and he should just
right.
Hold the shield. shows on it.
Jackson needed that.
Yeah, it was a good plan. You know, just watching the bike play, I think it launches mostly. You have too much range in neutral.
Yeah. Right.
When he attacks, he's pretty low to the ground, and a lot of his stuff's grounded. So I think the benefit Jax is not to implement running down to this match, but really kind of like the ball game and watching us make the watch try to open the
net. Right.
Those are what I like right there. Yeah, I mean, the cool thing about playing a low tier, like, this is...
And then a lot of the landing lag with Game & Watch, I don't think Blake L cancels too often.
Yeah, I mean, I think Blake will use some moves that do L cancel, but they're... I think Game & Watch has two aerials that don't L cancel, so they're basically useless moves.
Right.
Which is unfortunate. Yeah, Game & Watch is interesting because he has a lot of good things. Like,
his weight is a big weakness.
Yeah, I mean... I think Jackson also needs to win this match. It's just wasting a 6-point game of matches. That was a good game though for Jackson.
Absolutely, he needed that.
He had that nice comeback with the down air.
Like, right, yep.
To read the air message. And then he kind of just controlled the game.
Right. Instead of go to Dreamland, I don't know if Blake likes it here.
I mean, Jackson really isn't getting any.
Right.
I don't think this is going to matter that much. This way, good enough score that it won't matter too much. It's just going to be about who else plays it.
Right. Like I said, forget about that priority. So, Jackson just went for a down air.
Jackson got a down air.
And,
that was a smart move, but I think I agree
with
that. He was going to get beat.
Either way. He may have been able to take it off the stage if he was going that way. I don't know which direction the pressure would have sent him though.
I think it would have sent him to the left.
Right.
The only better option I think he could have really done was an air dodge just a little bit more. He's getting kind of greedy with the force matches. He's just looking patient.
Right.
Game Watch is so light that eventually just drive.
It's like that.
That's a cheesy forwards match.
Jaxus is a big fan of that forwards match though.
Yeah. He's very good for feeling that out.
There you go again.
Jaxus tries to make people to jump.
Right.
I don't even know if he makes it on purpose necessarily. I don't know. That's what he like goes for on purpose. He like has a good feel for what he wants to do.
Man, that's recovering the game once though.
Down smash is very good to kill floaties. Game Watch is definitely to kill floaties.
Absolutely. Again with those chain grabs, I think this is
that
Jackson's
like
thing to do.
Punish him. You see Marsh will temper down smash and kill Mistress.
Right. That neutral air, did you react out of your upbeat to the Game & Watch?
So, yeah, it's really
right.
Jax is going to make it back, and it'll be really good for the
makes it back, but let's see what that is. Yeah,
it's
maybe a good pick for Jaxus. I don't think that's going to pick, but...
The stage has worked out all
right. Right.
He's living a long time. And Game & Watch died in the stage.
So basically, Jaxus is going to get on the side of the stage in the Lord's hat.
Okay.
Ooh, reaching for that. Okay.
Yeah, that was a nice finish, but also, I didn't really see
it. That was intentional.
I didn't really see Jaxus go for the off the slash combo. Nice way dashing ground. I should see if that's a true combo.
I don't know if he's. Yeah, I don't think he has jump.
Yeah, you gotta be really careful with the combo. He's going over there. Right there on the shield. Yeah, you gotta be careful with the forward smashing.
Right.
Jaxus is fishing really hard. He's gonna end up hurting him.
Right. a little greedy. Yeah, exactly.
Really greedy.
So this one, this is exactly what Texas needed.
Yeah.
Here we go. I can take it.